Hi guys, this is Avinash Sharma, and in this session we will discuss the what is the normalization in database. Normalization means like designing the tables or database in such a way in a standard format that our DML statements, or we can say the data manipulation, is very smooth. If your database and table is not designed in a proper format, then you can face some kind of problems like insert, update and delete anomaly. What's the anomaly? We will discuss it later in details. And finally, we delete the redundancy. It means that we delete the useless data from the tables. Also, we delete the data dependency. After that, we can divide the large table into a small table, and then we create the relationship between those tables. And that relationship is called the primary key and foreign. Now, what is the anomaly? As you can see in the definition, something that is not according to standard or normal. It means the database, the design of your database and tables is not in a standard format. Standard format means like you cannot apply the DML statement proper way in that on that table. Suppose we have a table that is the, in this table we have the employee ID, name, address and department. So this employee ID 101, name is Rick, address Delhi, and department sales and purchase. It means this employee is engaged in two department. Then 123 and again 166, again this employee is engaged in the two department sales and purchase. And this column department is declared not null in table. So if we use this table for the DML purpose, it means for insert, update and delete, then what happens? In case of the insert, suppose in case of the insert, I want to enter the information of a new employee, but we have not assigned the department to that employee. So for now, I want to skip the department details of that employee. So if I do that, insert into MPID, ID, name, address. So I'm skipping the department. That is the not null. So it is not possible. So I cannot insert the information of the new employee without the department ID. And that is not the standard. Secondly, if I update the department of any employee on the basis of the ID 101, so I am changing the two rows. So there is no system, there is no mechanism in this table, so where I can recognize the row uniquely. Again, if I delete the data, so delete EMP where ID equal to 101, then I am deleting the say two row. So that is not the standard of the database. So this drawback should be removed. That's why we do the normalization on the database. Now, we will check the data anomaly on the SQL Server. So we have a table that is the EMP ID. If we check the data, then we have the ID 101101 Rick, and the Rick is engaged in two departments, sales and purchase. The same case is the John 105105. If you see in the left side, the CMP table, the all the columns are not null. It means if you want to add the details of the new employee, then you require all the information for all columns. But the case is, I want to enter the information of a new employee, but for now, I do not have the details of the department assigned to that new employee. So I want to enter the information of the new employee without the department. So you can see in the insert, insert into EMP, ID, name, address, and these are the value. So I'm skipping the department because no information for that department. So if I try this statement, then I get the error, cannot insert the null value into column department because that is the not null. So this is called the insert anomaly. The design of the table is not in standard format. Secondly, if I update, suppose I want to change the department of a Rick, then how to change that one? If I take the 101, then it's changing the two rows, this one, that one. So 101, IT, then again check. So department for both row is IT, not a standard. Update anomaly. And the same case is with the delete. If you delete, suppose you want to delete the record of employee, single record, then how to do that? It means in this table, and there is no standard where I can recognize the row uniquely. So this is called the data anomaly. Now, types of the normalization. There are six types, but in this section, we will cover up to the fourth. Here, one thing is very, very important. When you start normalizing the database or table, then you have to make sure you have to follow the stage. Suppose you are on the first stage, then that's fine. Then when you move to the next stage, then you have to make sure that this stage, this normalization, fulfills the criteria of the previous stage, it means the stage one. And when you are on the third stage, again, then you have to make sure this stage fulfills the criteria of the stage one in stage two. So this way you can move from first to fourth normal. So we will discuss all these stages in detail. Now we talk about the first normal form, and it has two conditions. Condition number one, that no column in this table should have the multiple values. And second condition, it should hold only the atomic value, forming a single unit. What it means? Atomic means that value cannot be divided. Say EMPID, we cannot divide this value. John, we cannot divide. Mobile number, we cannot divide this number, but Smith has two mobile numbers. So we can divide this value. So this value is not an atomic value. So this is not valid for the first normal form. So we have to remove this lacuna. So what to do? We have to create one more row for this Smith and another row for the Kim. Second condition is each record needs to be unique. So we have EMPID. EMPID are different. Even the combination of the EMPID, name, mobile number and department are unique. So second condition is already fulfilled. Only the problem is with the multiple value in the mobile number. We have a table. The problem is multiple value in this table. The solution is we create one more row for the Smith and divide the phone number, and we do the same thing for the Kim. See, so this is the solution after the normalization. This is the table. Now we have the condition. The condition one, no column should hold the multiple values. That condition is fulfilled now. So no column is having the multiple value. Second condition is each record needs to be unique. So we can combine the columns. Say EMPID, now EMPID 1, EMPID 2, 2. So there is no uniqueness in this column. So what to do? We can combine EMPID, name and mobile number, or we can combine EMPID and mobile number. So I think EMPID mobile number, this is the correct way to recognize the record uniquely. Now we talk about the second normal form. Before that, we check the data. We have a table, that is the EMPID, qualification and age. And we have the composite key, employee ID and qualification. This is the, why? Because we are entering the employee ID, then qualification, and again the same EMPID, but the qualification is different. So we want the uniqueness with the combination of these two, EMPID and qualification, because we do not want to repeat the qualification of the same employee ID. That's why we have the composite key, EMPID plus qualification. Another column, we have the age. This is called the non-key attribute because this is not part of the composite key. But this age is dependent on the EMPID. When we want to find out the age, then we will find the age on the basis of the EMPID. But the problem is EMPID, it should be a single primary key. But right now, it is a part of the composite key, EMPID plus qualification. So this is the condition of the second normal form. All non-key attributes, this one, age, fully functional dependent on the primary key, and this edge is dependent on the EMP ID. In simple words, it should not have partial dependency. This edge depends on the EMP ID, and EMP ID must be a primary key. But here we have the EMP ID is the part of this composite key, partial aapka dependency. So we have to remove this partial dependency. So this is the condition of the second normal form. Now we check on the SQL Server how the composite key works. We have a table that is the EMP, and we have the data, EMP ID, qualification and age, and these are the data. EMP ID and the qualification is the primary key, composite key combination, and we have the data 111 BTech, and another group is the 111 MA. So these two value combination must be the different in these two columns. Suppose I try to insert this value, the same again MA, and then I get the error, cannot insert duplicate key in the violation of the primary key. And if I say MA1, then it's done. I check the data. It means the combination of this MA1 and 111 is different from all other values. The problem is age, because here we have to maintain the qualification for each and every employee differently. The problem is age. Suppose I have to find out the age of the employees 111. If I execute this query, then I'm getting the three rows, and that is not a standard. Also, if I check the definition of the table, that is the EMP, so you can see we have two columns, EMP ID and qualification. So this is called the composite key, more than one column, EMP ID qualification. Now we talk about the third normal form. A table to be in third normal form, make sure it is in second normal form. Means this table, this stage fulfills the criteria of the second normal form. Then the rule is there is no transitive functional dependency. This is the important. We have a table that is the EMP ID name, zip and city. In this zip and city, these are the non-key columns, and city is dependent on the zip, because for each and every city a unique zip is assigned, and if you change the zip, then also you need to change the name of the city in the database. So it means the city is dependent on the zip, and zip is dependent on the EMP ID, that's a primary key. So here we can see the city dependent on zip, and zip dependent on the EMP ID. So indirectly, city is dependent on the EMP ID. So this indirect dependency is called the transitive functional dependency. So if this functionality is there, transitive functional dependency is there in the table, then we have to remove that one. And once we remove that one, then the tables becomes the third normal form. So how to do that one? Now the solution is divide that table into two tables. One is the EMP table. In this table we have the EMP ID, that is the now primary key. Then name and the zip. And in this table, there is no column independent to each other. All columns are dependent on the EMP ID, that is the single primary key. Other table is the zip table. Again, zip now is the primary key, and city is the non-primary key table data column. So if we observe all the criteria of the previous stage, the first normal form, it was that no column should have the multiple values. There is no multiple value in this table. Secondly, that each row should be recognized as a unique row, and then we have the EMP ID unique, so we can recognize the whole row on the basis of EMP ID. Second stage, and the criteria of the second normal form was there should be no transitive functional dependency, and so all columns name and zip, they are independent, they don't depend to each other. So this way, this table is now in third stage, third normal form. Now we talk about the Boy Scout normal form, and it is called the BCNF. It's an advanced version of the third normal form. Sometimes it is called the 3.5 version. In this form, we have a rule. If every functional dependency A depend B, then A has to be a super key. What do you mean? We have a table, student ID, subject, professor, and student 101 Cal can opt the multiple subjects. Say 101 Java and the same subject, the same student, and the subject is the C++. Different subject. The professor can teach only one subject but can teach the multiple students. So in this table, we have a relation, student ID and subject. The combination of these two, we have uniqueness. This one. But the problem is, the professor is dependent on the subject. If you change the subject, then professor also change. So this dependency should not be there. If it is there, then subject has to be a primary key or super. Again, the solution is divide that table into two tables. Now we have two tables, that is the student table, and in this table we have the student ID and the professor ID. This ID, professor ID, is coming from another table, that is the professor table. And this ID, professor ID, say we can have the auto generated ID, then professor name and the subject taught by this professor. So every time you add a professor and subject, then this ID is also incremented. And in this student ID, we are assigning the professor ID. So we have the details of this professor and subject through this professor ID. So now on this stage, there is no multiple value in this any column, and we have the uniqueness in this, and there is no functional transit functional dependency on this table. So all the criteria of the previous stage are fulfilled. So now this table is in now Boyce Codd normal form stage. Now we talk about the fourth normal form. So to be in fourth normal form, we have to make sure that all the criteria of the previous stage are already fulfilled. The rule for the fourth normal form is, it has no multi-value dependency. What I mean? We have a table, student ID, course, and hobby. For the student ID 21, we have the computer, then hobby dancing. Again, the same student 21, course is math, and hobby is singing. Multiple course and multiple hobbies. And in this table, the course and hobby, these are the two columns, non-primary columns. And these two columns are dependent on the student ID. It means course is dependent on the student ID and hobby is dependent on the student ID. And there is no dependency to each other in the course and hobby. So if this is the case, then we have to remove the multi-value dependency from this table. Solution is again divide the table. So we have to divide the table. Now one table is the student course table and another one is the student hobby table. So in this case, student ID, then course opted by the students, multiple course and multiple student ID. And the same thing, hobbies, multiple hobbies and multiple student ID. So this way we have removed the multi-value dependency from the table. Now the form is in the fourth normal form. So guys, this was all about the how to normalize the database. I hope you understood everything. Thanks for watching the video.